don't be a slave to your inbox. You know, turn off those notifications. Don't constantly be checking it. Turn them off on your computer and your phone. How's it going, everybody? Great to see you guys again, and wanted to talk about some productivity tactics today. You know, it's Thursday, so I like to talk about tactics on Thursday. And I was thinking about this today because, you know, it's coming up towards Christmas and things are starting to wind down at the office. I actually did my last day at the office before Christmas now today. I've got a few meetings and a few little bits and pieces to clear up the next couple of days, but down to the vacation. And so just looking forward to some time off, spending time with my wife and my daughter and hanging out here in DFW. So can't wait for that. But then it made me reflect on, actually today I didn't receive very many emails compared to how much I usually do. And it's something that I've been working on quite a bit, you know, in the background. A few years ago, I read a tweet by a guy called Robert Scobles. And for anyone who doesn't know who Robert Scobles is, and I'm probably butchering his name, by the way, it's probably not Scobles, it's probably something completely different. But he is one of the guys who was, I think, very early on in Rackspace and was one of the sort of architects of cloud computing. And being in that space and be, you know, driving a lot of, you know, large scale server farm implementations and what have you, he, in the early days of the internet, he just received and sent and, you know, just generally got through a lot of emails. And he got quite frustrated at one time with the amount of emails that he was getting through and was getting into his inbox, and it was just something that he couldn't keep up with. He's a very clever guy, so what he did was a little bit of analysis, and he found out that for every email that he sent, he received 1.4 emails back. So, being the sort of succinct guy that he is, he said, well, therefore, if I stop sending any emails, I will receive much, you know, proportionally 1.4 times fewer emails than I received before. So, he did that. He stopped sending emails, he stopped sending them, he stopped replying to them, he stopped using his email completely. And within less than a week, his email volume dropped to next to zero. Now, I know what your guys are thinking, like, yeah, well, it's great for him, you know, he could have done it. I tried this myself, and I got my email volume down to a very manageable size very quickly by just sending many fewer emails. So I have a couple of things that I do with my email that help me not spend all of my time in my inbox. And I think that those help me be a lot more focused when I'm at the office and I can actually get stuff done much quicker because I'm not getting distracted. So the things that I would recommend that you try doing is, firstly, don't look at your email the first, you know, first thing in the morning. Don't look at it on your phone. Get into work. Have in the day two slots where you primarily look at emails. One sort of, I like to look at mine mid-morning, and then again maybe later on in the afternoon just to see what else has gone on. From my point of view, I work a lot with Europe and I'm based here in the US, so I get the bulk of my emails of when I wake up and then, you know, through the morning, and then by late morning it's starting to tail off quite dramatically the number of emails I get, as is the number of meetings that I have. So I'm quite lucky on my afternoon is usually stretched to, you know, so that I can be more productive in the afternoon because I don't have meetings and emails that need looking at. But so I would definitely try and check your emails only on two occasions. One thing that helps me do that is I disable all of the email alerts on my computer. So my computer gives me no, my laptop gives me no alerts, Outlook gives me no alerts on my screen or anything when I receive emails or when I receive meeting invitations. I've had that disabled for years and I don't miss it one bit. If I'm curious, I'll go in and find out. The only alert I have is meeting alerts. So that's the main alert that I work off of. And it works a lot for me. The other thing is that I just don't reply to emails unless they are something that's really important. I like to try and call people. I use a lot of Teams Messenger, a bit of Jabber, Cisco Jabber, which is the chat application we have in Tetra Pak. And predominantly now a lot more sort of just SMS and phone calling people. I find that I can resolve things and I can resolve meetings much quicker in just a phone call than I can in, you know, a whole email thread. So I think it's a much more effective use of time, and it's a much better way of time. Going on to that, there's another talk that you know that I could go into about reducing meetings and minimizing meetings. That's I think a topic for another video, but I just wanted to talk about this and just mention, you know, don't be a slave to your inbox. You know, turn off those notifications. Don't constantly be checking it. Turn them off on your computer and your phone, and then make sure. Now, I know that some of you will be in customer facing roles, and then you might be concerned that the turnaround time for replying to an email is. But even if you're trying to set 2 slots a day only to look at your emails, the likelihood is that you're going to check those emails much more often. And also, Outlook has the ability that you can prioritize external emails, for example, that only get notifications. So give it a go. I recommend you give it a go for a week. Disable those notifications. Stop replying to emails, you know, that might seem urgent but really aren't. And I think that you'll find that your email volume will drop and your productivity at work will go up. Hope you enjoyed this video. If you're watching us on YouTube, please give us a like. Please think about subscribing and selecting the notifications. And most of all, if you enjoy my videos, please share them with your friends. And I'll speak to you all tomorrow.